Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to this HTML5 series. And in this video, we are starting second module. So in the first module, we have already covered the basics of HTML5, what all new tags, what all the new attributes has been added in HTML5. We talked about the form validations, how to write forms, the basic layout creations with the header, footer and all. So that was just about the basics of HTML5. Now we are moving towards the advance of HTML5. In that, what we are going to cover is about DOM HTML5 chat sheet, in which we will just cover all the tags introduced in HTML5. Then we will understand what is a tag element attribute, what all different attributes different elements is having, like image tag is having src, alt, or anchor tag is having href attribute. So all these things, then feature detection, what features are enabled on different browsers, all the new elements introduced in HTML5. Then most importantly, these are the new features like canvas drawing, video and audio support, that you can just, if you have audio file, you will be able to play. If you have MP4 file or any video file, then you will be able to play on your website. There is a new feature, then the web storage APIs, where we'll talk about how you can store the data. Geolocation APIs to access the location of access your location. If you are opening that website, then it will ask you, it will take the permissions, and using the navigator object, it will be able to detect your location. Then offline web apps, how we deal with this, and most importantly, how web workers works with browser and how this WebSocket works. Then we'll talk about quickly the CSS, about CSS3 and CSS, like what is the box model. We'll talk about border, padding, margin, different positions and different layouts. So we'll just see all these things in nutshell. Okay, how to define a border, what is a box sizing, how to define a color, font, font family, font weight, different media queries to make your UI look responsive. Okay, multi-column layout, different kind of selectors. We can use different ways of adding a style, either using ID, either using a class. So there is a specificity rule. If you write any CSS inline, then it will get a higher preference. If you write some CSS in your different file, and if you are using classes, if you are using ID, or you are writing inline styles, so what is the preference? Which particular style will get preference over on top of each other? So there, that is a specificity rule, and that we will just try to understand. Okay, so in CSS, finally, we'll just talk about the CSS. We'll just try to create a nice layout where we will try to just customize it. We'll use all these margin, padding, background image, all these media query stuff, and try to make our layout responsive also. And we'll try to create a multi-column layout. In the modern development, we can use n number of things. You can use a flex box, you can use a bootstrap, and you don't need to worry about a lot of CSS, because it is giving you already a responsive grid. So you just consume the responsive grid, you put your blocks into responsive grid. But initially, we are just at a beginner level, so we are just trying to understand the core. Okay, how we can divide the body into two parts. In the left hand part, I can put some text, in the right hand side, I can put some image, some video, or some background image. So how we can create a content left and right, how you can just float them, how you can just split the horizontal width of your body into 50-50%, how to center the content, how to set a global font family. Okay, and in future, we'll just talk about the sash and all, how you can just define the styles using class names, using ID selectors, or using inline styles, different ways. So there are different options to even put the styles, either inline style, or either you can just put the style tag. So I'm just talking about it here. You can put a style tag. Inside that, you can define your styles. Here, types text styles, or you can just create a separate index.css, and you can define your styles and just put it, link it here. Link rel style sheet. Okay, and just put a href is an attribute, and it will be your location of that style sheet. This is how you can add a style sheet in your page. Okay, different ways of doing this. So we are going to cover a lot of things, and Let's see, let's start with the module 2 of this crash course.